Hi, I'm Anindita Roy and I'm a plus size fashion influencer and a model, and the most important thing that I talk about is body positivity. Let's first start how and why I became a body positive influencer or so-called plus size fashion influencer. You know, a lot of people ask me that, you know, why can't you just say fashion influencer, why plus size? You know, I actually don't want to call it just fashion influencer. I want to call it a plus size fashion influencer because there's a reason behind it. You know, people doesn't understand that, you know, there is a lot of humiliation and rejection and a lot of bullying and shaming that has gone into it. So as a kid, I was very thin. I was perfect to be, if you have to say so. So yeah, I was perfect, as the society would call me, as a kid. But once I started hitting my puberty, which was when I was almost 12 years old, I suddenly started putting on weight. Okay, and I just didn't know like what was happening to my body and why was it happening. I would play like any kids would do. Like I would play for 2 hours in the evening and still could not control from putting on that weight. And suddenly, before I could even realize that, you know, what was happening to me, I had gained that weight, and now I was called a fat girl. So yeah, I mean, I could see people like, you know, around, not my friends, not my family, but you know, lot of people around would make fun of me. Even like, you know, when I was used to go back, my father had a transferable job. So whenever I used to go back to our house in Calcutta, so my uncle, you know, used to like tease me, which I used to not like, because, you know, I mean, not that he teased me with an intention, but you know, it just, you know, you don't feel comfortable with that kind of teasing because you know you're fat and you know you are not. You are not responsible for it, and you know you are doing everything. And I think my mother and I tried every possible thing. I went to the gym, I did yoga, I think I did everything, but nothing actually helped. Then came a point when I went to Delhi for my college, which is Miranda House, and I think that is when I started gaining a little bit of confidence about myself. Before that, you know, till like class 11-12, I used to wear only salwar, churidars and dupattas. Like, just think, a teenage girl, okay, going for a tuitions wearing a full suit, okay, that's humorous, like, you know, that's really funny, like, you know. So then I went to college and then I dropped the first piece of clothes, that was dupatta, and I shifted to wearing a patiala and kurti, and I felt little better. Okay, so okay, the dupatta is dropped. Then came the winters, and you know, winters you can't wear patialas. So I actually bought, my father actually bought me a pair of jeans, and he used to keep telling me that, you know, why can't you wear western clothes? What is stopping you? You are just fat. I mean, that doesn't make you any different from any other girl. You can wear the same stuff and look good. You don't have to hide yourself. I think my father was quite he was quite forward that way, and he used to support me a lot. Even my mother did her bit, but I think yeah, my father was a big supporter. And so I wore that denim, and I felt really nice about myself after wearing the denim. Sleeveless never happened for next 7 or 8 years. Sleeveless never happened, never ever. Short clothes never ever happened. Then came a time when I shifted to Bombay, which was in 2014, and you know, that is when I think in 2013 I wore a kurti, a sleeveless kurti without dupatta. That was a big step for me. But in 2014, when I moved to Bombay, finally, that is when I actually left all inhibitions in my life, and I started wearing a lot of things which I didn't used to. So, which included short clothes, sleeveless clothes, everything. But yeah, still, like, you know, not very short clothes, or not like very, not like a halter, never happened. Then came a point in 2016 when I started dating a guy. You know, earlier, like how every romance, and you know, how every begins with lot of wooing, and you know, from the boy's side, it happened. And then suddenly it reached a point after 2 months when he kept saying that, you know, I really think that you have a pretty face, but you have an ugly body. That actually broke me. And then came when he used to mentally torture me a lot. like, you know, not because I'm fat, but because of various reasons. Because he I don't know how his upbringing was, but you know, I don't know, he used to, like, you know, he used to humiliate me a lot in lot of ways. So I had lost all my confidence by then. In 2017 we parted ways, and I think that was the best thing that happened in my life that year. And that is when I started thinking that what am I doing with my life. That's when I was speaking to my junior, my friend Ria, and you know, she suggested that, you know, you have got a great fashion sense, you wear a lot of things, like, you know, you actually kind of break fashion stereotypes, fashion rules. You're doing so much, why don't you show your piece of work to the world? And that is when I started my Instagram account. Actually, she taught me how to do it. I couldn't Instagram before. So on 28 December 2017, I started my Instagram page, The Plus Girl. And by God's grace and my hard work, in a year's time, I have around 12,000 followers now. People from all over the world appreciates my work. My work has been appreciated by publications like Words and Rediff and, you know, News 18. And recently I was featured in Cosmopolitan Jan issue. I think, you know, I'm actually every day trying to do stuff which break fashion stereotypes. Even when I collaborate with brands, I keep in mind that, you know, I will wear only clothes which a lot of fat women don't really think of wearing. They think that maybe this is not suited to their body type, but yeah, I am breaking those fashion stereotypes. Actually, the other day I recently met someone at my new workplace, and she said that, you know, whenever I think of not wearing that dress, I go to your page and I kind of check you out, and I go back and wear that dress which I didn't have the courage to. So I think, yeah, I am influencing a lot of people, and I'm motivating other people, and that's what keeps me going. And I think my followers also give me a lot of confidence to kind of do a lot of good work. So that's my story. Yep. Thank you.